3RW Breakfast. Good to have you here. 12 to 8. So we've been talking this morning about a little device that you wear, like a Fitbit, but you wear it for sleep. And I think you stick it on your forehead. And the way we've been explaining it is the gist of it is you wake up and HAL 2000 turns to you and says, I'm sorry, Dave, you had a bad night's sleep.
That was a shocker.
That was an awful sleep, Dave. You tossed and turned and snored quite a lot, and I didn't get a wink myself. But it's a new device that is coming on the market.
It is, and someone should be able to tell us a little bit more helpful information than just, I'm sorry, Dave, you had a bad sleep. It's Dr. David Burton, founder and chief executive of Compumedics, who make the Somfit. Good morning to you, Doctor.
Good morning. Thanks, Justin and Kate.
No problems. Can you tell us, how does it work?
Well, the device, it's like a small pendant, size of around a 20-cent piece, that can be attached to the forehead via what's effectively like wearing a Band-Aid. But what's unique about it, it actually does measure your brain waves, your muscle tonicity, and your eye movement. So it can give you true sleep, and that's sleep quality. So you get to determine and track what your architecture is, your sleep, which is quite different to many of the gimmicks.
So, David, the question is just why? Why would I wear it? What am I going to get out of it? What do I do with that information when I have it?
Well, great question. Firstly, we need to know what happens if we don't get a good sleep, and then what we can do to measure it and what about it. If we don't get a good sleep, for example, it's during dream sleep that our brain consolidates. So we'll be rattled during the day, to put it simply. Our kids won't be able to think as effectively. So you need brains that deep REM sleep, the dream sleep, and that's for the brain restoration. And then you need stage 3 sleep, which is for body restoration. So even athletes or fitness individuals need to have that deep sleep for body recovery. And that can only be determined in terms of the mind and the body state, which means it must measure brain waves at least to give you true sleep. Now, once you've measured that, we have our professional software migrated to the cloud. You wake up, you can have a look, even if it's down to simply 5 stars, as to what your goal and requirements for true sleep are. If you're not getting effective sleep, that could be because you're not getting the right stages of sleep or the quality.
David, do you mind if I jump in here and ask you, though? Does that not create a little bit of, and I'm not talking your product down, good on you for it, and I hope it goes well, but does it not create a little bit of pressure that, oh, gee, you know, I only got 3 stars last night, I've got to go for 5 tonight. Does that not create a little anxiety?
Well, it does, but, you know, most people suffer sleep deprivation. And sleep deprivation, some studies show, for example, 4-fold increased vulnerability just to the common cold. So, yes, it will create some pressure, but for very good reason. A lot of mental disorders, stress, anxiety, are related to not having good sleep. So you're exactly right, it will create some pressure. And what you just said is a perfect example of what the device is for. It'll create some awareness more than pressure or stress, by the way. And then you'll be able to link in experts such as your GP and specialist who can indeed help you do something about it. Plus you yourself, if you can measure your sleep, then you can manage it better.
Idea, David? So if I get up very early for breakfast radio, if I know I need a certain amount of hours to get to stage 3 sleep, does that then tell me if you're getting up at that time, you need to be in bed by this time in order to get the best sleep possible? Is that how we're using it?
Well, that's a good example. If you have a large proportion of the population have what we call sleep delay syndrome or sleep phase syndrome, and that's where your actual propensity to sleep, your desire to sleep, doesn't align with your day or work activities. And if that's the case, you may well be lying on the pillow and experience this. You're not getting the quality deep sleep. You could be wasting your time. You think you're getting a long sleep, but it's a fractured or fragmented or disrupted sleep. So if we can see that and it's true sleep, then yes, we can start to manage our time and do something about it.
David, thank you. Very last question. How did you sleep last night?
Well, unfortunately, I haven't got one of these Somfit devices, so it's not as well as I could if I had one.
No, fair enough. Dr. David Burton, that's a good answer, founder of chief executive of Compumedics. You need